Every time Kareem is late, it costs me money. I got mixed up with my third wife because she was supposed to meet Kareem. He didn't show up. She wound up with me. I'm still paying alimony, brother. I don't appreciate that.
Should have followed my example.
No, you need a bodyguard, because you know how Stevie Wonder told you how it was. When he told that girl to put on that red dress. You know, this is great for me. Elgin Baylor. I'm lucky this is my second time being at an unveiling of a legend. Bill Russell, we had fun over there, didn't we, Bill? You gotta nod, hey, had fun, man. Come on, brother. What's wrong with you? You know, it's odd that I'm here because I never knew Elgin Baylor, the basketball player. His basketball playing career ran concurrently with my 9-year Navy career. And while he was playing basketball, I was traveling all over the world looking for stuff. You know what I'm talking about, Jack. I even went to New Orleans looking for John the Conqueror root. And them friendly women I heard they got down there with a kink in the thing they do to you. But I knew who Elgin Baylor was from the many military basketball courts that I visited, filled with guys who couldn't jump over their shadow trying to be Elgin Baylor. But I knew who Elgin Baylor was then, but now I only know Elgin Baylor the man. I got to know him in our late 60s or early 70s from being included in his and Elaine's favorite pastime, having folks over for dinner. Their guests have ranged from Mike Stoller and Corky Hale to Penny Marshall and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Think he was on time, couple time. The routine is always the same. Elaine cooks, oh God, and lays out a beautiful spread. We all eat, fellowship, express our admiration for each other, and then Elgin washes the dishes. Yep. Boy, this thing is crazy. Elgin washes dishes. Hey, I didn't come here on a scholarship. Things out of here, man. Yes, no matter how late it is, and no matter how many catnaps he has taken during dinner and conversation, of course, if you ask him, he was just resting his eyes. Only man I ever met who rests his eyes with his mouth gap wide open. Maybe he's resting his jaws too, huh? Anyway, no matter how late it is, immediately after the festivities are finished, Elgin springs to life, jumps up and washes the damn dishes. Now, after a few visits and seeing this ritual repeat itself, as soon as you leave their beautiful castle in the sky, you can't wait to have a serious conference with your wife in your car. Word for word, you exclaim, "Look, I know what you just saw, but I want to establish right now so we don't wind up in some kind of revolution of rising expectations. I don't care how much you cook or who you cook it for. I ain't washing no damn dishes. Call one of them dishwashing services. Call your mama, whoever or whenever. I ain't doing it." But you've got to let him tell you how he got his dishwashing fetish. He explains it in his book, Hang Time. Remember that word, Hang Time. You won't be disappointed. Get the book. But that's just Elgin. Elgin is not ashamed to lift the burden of cleanup after cooking from the shoulders of his beloved wife, Elaine, or be openly affectionate to her in public. Openly affectionate to her in public. Shaq, don't give me no more of that chewing gum. You put one that mess my tongue up, boy. As he puts it, she means everything to me. And if you know Elgin like I know him, if he said it, that's what he meant. He is a glaring example that macho doesn't mean being too tough to consider others or show compassion when it's needed. Part of his greatness is his acute awareness of the point where basketball ends and life begins. Anyone who can combine into the same persona, scoring 71 points in an NBA game, 61 in an NBA playoff finals game, and the guy who washes the damn dishes after his wife has fed 30 people, definitely has a firm grip on how much of what makes a man. I can recall a time when I was having difficulty. Yes, thank you. My dog Corey's out there. I told you, Corey. I can recall a time when I was having difficulty processing an uncomfortable reality. After listening to countless attempts by well-meaning friends offering various solutions, Elgin simply stated, "I understand." That did it for me. That's all I needed, somebody who understood. If you're out and about, you may see Elgin pushing the shopping cart through Costco or some market like Ralph's or Pavilion's. Yes, folks, Elgin does the shopping too. He can tell you which items are a bargain and which ones are overpriced. Bless his heart, he may be the most equally contributing husband to a happy and well-run household on God's green earth. As I told you earlier, I'm not a basketball aficionado, but even I know that your beloved Los Angeles Lakers rode into town initially on the shoulders of Elgin Baylor. Jerry West and many other superstars were eventually to follow, but Elgin was the first. He was the leader who shepherded them into town and watched over them when they got here. That alone should earn him immortality in Laker lore. But he also played up to and beyond the reputation that preceded him here. 71 points? Come on, man. If I went out in the driveway by myself, I'd have to eat two meals, go to the bathroom 6 or 7 times before I got 71. Let's be real, the brother was bad, y'all know that. Uh-oh, Sonny, here we go. To clean up a phrase used by those who played. Elgin Baylor was a basketball player, figuratively incestuous with his mother, brother. It's gonna take you a minute, but you'll catch up in a minute. The composite of Elgin Baylor, the basketball player, and Elgin the man makes him more than worthy of the honor you're bestowing on him today. And you too should feel an unburdening. You will no longer have to bear the burden of being asked over and over, year after year, why doesn't Elgin Baylor have a statue in front of the Staples Center? Score one for the universe in the Department of Fair Play. Elgin, long-legged sucker. I love you, brother. Don't look at me like that, Kareem. Look like you just ate a kumquat or something. Don't look like you just ate a plate of liver. My man, that's my buddy. Soak it all in, bud. As one of the boys back home might say, look what they gonna do for you for what you done for them. Yeah, brother, you've been busted this evening. I even made a rhyme for you. I ain't gonna charge you for this one. The bus is on the Lakers. You got a bust in the Hall of Fame. Now we're gonna bust this statue out on you, brother. and celebrate your mighty game.